wanna be, living like there's only me. But now I spend my time thinking about a way to get you off my mind. Yeah.
Okay, today we're coming live from Phoenix Primary School in Fairfield. Hey, come on. Pathetic. Right, so we've got a small group here. They've just done their own radio programme. First time they've done radio as well, isn't it? Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, and we're gonna start off by going around, and they're going to introduce themselves, and they're going to speak in a really nice, loud, clear voice. What's your name?
Emma.
Megan.
Tom.
Right, okay. Omar,
Emma,
Megan, and Tom.
Tom.
Right, okay. I'm going to ask you first of all, I'm going to ask Omar and Megan. No, that's Megan, isn't it?
Yeah, that's Megan.
Emma. It's all right, Emma, don't worry. It happens to you when you get old. I'm going to ask each of you what you did your radio program about. So I'm going to start off with Omar. What was your radio program about, Omar? You know, the radio show that you've just done, what was it about? What were you talking about on your radio program?
What was your name?
All right, okay. So you had to tell everyone what your name was. Because where do you come from, Omar?
From Syria.
Syria. Why are you in Britain now? Why are you in Liverpool?
Because it's to have trouble.
There's a big war going on, isn't there? There's lots of people getting killed. So he's come all the way here to get away from all the trouble, which is good, isn't it? Do you enjoy living in Liverpool?
Yeah.
Why do you enjoy living in Liverpool?
Yes, I like it.
Do you like the people?
Yeah.
Because we're all friendly, aren't we?
Yeah.
You're going to be a scouser when you grow up?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. Right, Emma, come on. What was your programme about?
My programme was about ambulances.
Ambulances?
Ambulance drivers.
Right, okay. So did you get a guest in?
What?
Did you get a guest in to interview?
Yeah.
Who was
No, it wasn't an actual one. I was in an actual one.
Oh, right,
it was
okay.
A first aider.
So what did you find out about ambulances that you didn't know before?
When they come to you, they drive really fast, and they help people, and if it's really bad, they can put a bandage
around you. Yeah, you lost to you in the ambulance, can't they now? You take to hospital so you can get fixed up, can't you?
Yeah.
I was in an ambulance last year. I'm seriously ill.
Really?
Heart attack, yeah. Had a heart attack. I'm all right now.
How did your heart attack you?
It went, ah!
No, it didn't.
And I said, get a stick and batter it down.
But since that was your heart, then...
Yeah. I killed myself, yeah. Right, so I take it that you, Tom and Emma did the same programme, yeah?
Yep.
Yeah, okay.
So you don't need to ask me.
What was the best bit about your programme that you liked? Did you do it as well?
No.
No, you did a different one, didn't you? So I'm asking Tom and Emma now. So what was the best bit about your programme? What did you learn most about it, or what did you enjoy most?
I enjoyed sitting down and talking into the mic.
Right. Did you enjoy writing the script?
Yeah.
No, you didn't enjoy writing the script?
Yeah.
Why not? Why didn't you enjoy writing the script?
I don't like writing on typing on computers.
Oh, what about you, Emma? Did you enjoy writing the script? Yeah.
Yeah.
What did you enjoy writing? Did you enjoy doing the research and finding out things? Yeah.
And I like typing on the computers.
Yeah, that's good. Good. Tell me one of the questions that you asked the ambulance person who came in.
What shall I do if I cut my finger, and why?
Alright, what was the answer to that?
Because...
You have to put pressure on it, don't you think? You have to,
yes. No, go to a teacher.
Oh, go to a teacher? Alright, okay. See, that's a good idea. You have to report accidents that were in school. Didn't know you were talking about it.
I was a teacher.
Okay, let's move on a little bit, okay? Just introduce yourself again. Because you've got a little weenie voice, haven't you? Well, what's your name again?
Megan.
Megan, what was your programme about, Megan?
About teachers.
About teachers? Did you interview a teacher in your programme? Did you have a teacher come in to interview?
No.
No? Didn't you? So what did you find out about teachers? I Bear just told me that there was a teacher in your programme. teacher did come in. Who was it? Is it a secret?
Miss Mitchell.
No, it was Miss Evans.
Miss Evans, was it?
That was our one.
Oh, right. Oh, sorry.
It's not the teacher. He's
okay. Okay, and did you enjoy doing it, Megan? Did you enjoy doing the programme?
Yeah.
Which bit did you enjoy the most? You've got a tiny, tiny little voice, haven't you?
I...
Did you enjoy the music?
Yeah.
Okay, what else did you enjoy?
I enjoyed...
Did you enjoy speaking? Speaking, but did you enjoy speaking on the microphone? Did you enjoy speaking?
Yeah.
Did anybody not enjoy speaking on the microphone? Why is that, Tom?
I was doing that because I had an itch.
Well, right, okay.
The first,
yes, I had an itch.
The first time I didn't like it.
Didn't like it. Didn't like the first. Did you like the first time you heard your own voice? No, no one does, you know. But what do you feel about going on the radio now and talking on the radio?
Good.
You feel good about it. Do you want to do it again? Would you like to do it again?
Yeah.
Who'd like to do it again?
Me.
Well, you, Tom. You haven't put your hand up. Would you like to do it again?
No.
No, you wouldn't. Okay, well, we'll make you do it again. You might do another project again. And we'd like to work with a group that's already done somewhere. So you do a longer programme with more script. And he's not going to do it because he doesn't like it, does he? Right. I'm going to go round. It's the last thing we're going to do. I'm going to go round and I want you to say one word about the radio programme. Like, you might have thought it was brilliant.
One word.
Sentence.
One word.
Oh, hello.
So, I cycle a lot. If someone said to me, give me one word about cycling, I'd say exhilarating. Right, now you don't know what that means. It's a bit of a waste of time, isn't it?
But
it
tell
means,
me.
Means it's exciting. I couldn't say that exciting, really. So I'm going to ask you to say one word about the radio programme, and we're going to start with Omar.
I can't say anything.
You can't say anything, can you? If you're going to say it in Arabic, what would it be? Do you speak Arabic, do you?
No, it's not Arabic. It's a different one.
What is it? Aramaic or something like that? Is it?
It's.
No, it's okay. We'll start with Tom then. One word about the radio. What would you describe in one word?
Fantastic.
Fantastic. Okay. Megan.
Good.
Good. What about you?
Brilliant.
Can I say a different one?
Yeah, go on. Say a different one, Tom.
Excellent.
Fascinating. That's a great word. That's fascinating.
Excellent.
Excellent. Well done.
Excellent.
Well done.
Excellent.
Well done. Give me five. Ow.
I know one again.
Go on. Go on, Megan.
Oh.
I think so.
Come on, Megan. We're all waiting for it.
A star.
It's a bit like that advert on the toilet paper, isn't it?
A star.
Okay, that was brilliant. Give yourselves a round of applause. Fantastic. We'll get another group in now. Thanks for coming. Right, here we are in, where are we, which school are we in today?
Phoenix Primary School
in Fairfield. And we've got a small group of young people. There's three young ladies and one young man. And we're going to talk about...
No, it's two people. Because he's actually a boy.
Are you a
he's
boy? Oh, down. I'm really sorry about that. I'm really sorry.
See, why did that happen?
I'd have
it
like that, but do you understand my problem? Okay, Dave's the same. So I'm really sorry about that. I apologise most profoundly. Right, we're going to go left to right and we're going to introduce ourselves. So
wait, left to this side?
No, my left.
That's right.
There's always one in the group, isn't there always one in the group? Right, what's your name? Okay, what's your name?
Mazan.
What's your name?
Mia.
And Alex.
Alex,
okay. I'm going to ask you, each of you, what you did your radio programme on. So what was your radio programme on about?
Teachers.
It was about teachers. Did you do it with Megan?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because we just had Megan in before. What did you do your programme on, Mazan?
Divers.
Oh, I heard all about the divers one. You worked with Sheila, didn't you? I know, Sheila. Right, what do you your programme on?
Ambulances.
Oh, ambulances. I've heard that one as well. You, Tom and Emma, was it?
You were. And you know which one I did.
Right, and you did one on animal safety.
Yes.
Right, okay. And what did you think about doing your programme? Did you enjoy doing them? And if you did enjoy them, why?
Yeah.
What was the best bit?
I guess you could say I did.
Okay, what did you enjoy about doing it, Maza?
I enjoyed when we get to put the helmet on.
Oh, right.
Me and Cameron.
I heard all about this helmet. Was it a big metal helmet, was it? Or, yeah. And could you look like that? It's like Darth Vader. Okay, so what did you find out about divers, Marzan, that you didn't know before?
That they do swim with sharks.
Right, so oh,
and
swim with
sharks.
And you
see women.
Right, okay.
Mermaids don't exist.
And what did you find out about ambulances you used to?
It was me and Emma.
Right, what did you find out about ambulances?
You have to put bandages on them, and if they're really hurt, you can call 999.
Right, so where do you take them in the ambulance if they're really sick?
The hospital.
Accidents, an emergency. Alex, what was your show about again?
Animal safety.
And what was the main things that you told people about in your program?
Safety around dogs.
Yeah. You got to be careful with dogs, haven't you? Yeah. Okay. Where did you find out all this information from that you had in your programmes?
Well, with our teachers.
Off your teachers.
I found it from Steve.
Right, Steve.
I found most of it off the internet.
So you went to say something. The internet. What about you? What did you find out? Where did you find your information?
I don't think she knows.
She doesn't know. Okay, well, that's all right. You don't have to know everything. You, me and Dave know everything.
Yeah.
Okay, right. I'm going to ask you one thing now. I'm going to ask you to say one word, right? And that word is what you thought about doing the radio programme. I'm going to start with Alex. Just one word.
Epic.
Epic. Brilliant word. Epic.
Awesome.
Awesome. Oh my God, we've got some great words today, haven't we? Come on, Mazza.
Cool.
Cool. What about you? What's
I was going to do supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, but that might take a while.
Fantastic.
That was fantastic. Right.
Really fantastic.
You can ask me one question. Right, Mazan first.
What is your job?
My job. I've got a couple of jobs, but one of them, I run the radio station that this is part of, and I get the money in to pay for the training, to pay Dave, so he can go to your schools. And I'm also a governor of your school as well. I'm a governor of the school because I only live around the corner.
My dad's the governor at my school.
Is he?
He is not.
He is.
He isn't.
He is.
And Emma.
He is.
What's your question?
How old are you?
How old are you? That's a bit personal, that.
82.
I'll give you a clue. I'm younger than Dave.
You're 82.
What? 82.
You're not older than him.
Yeah, I'm not quite that old. I'm at 58 years old.
What?
58?
2 weeks.
How old am I?
Yeah.
59. I'm nearly 60. I get my bus pass.
82.
How old is
he? One tick on the time in a lonely world today. You
were. He's 2 years older than me, so he's. Did you get your bus pass?
No.
Why?
So you're
my mum's she's only like 49. Wait,
right,
my mum's 49.
One more question from
Massa.
Do you have any children?
I have 3 children. I have a son who's 33. I have another son who's 29.
And you don't even have a girl.
And I have a daughter. She's 27, and guess what my daughter does?
What?
She's a primary school teacher.
What's her name?
Her
name?
Hannah.
What?
Does she work in this school?
No, she doesn't.
She works in Sainsbury.
Nice, she gets a full-time job.
Sainsbury.
She's a supply teacher. You know the teachers that come and the teachers are sick? She's one of those teachers.
Okay.
Right, what I think we should do before we finish is give yourselves a round of applause. Cause
Hello, one, two, three, hello, Venice.
Okay,
we'll see if we can do some more later on.
Baby, stay away.
Voices today. Okay, not allowed. Okay, we're in. What school are we in today?
Phoenix.
That's right. Well, shout out where we school are we in.
You said Phoenix.
Okay, we're in Phoenix School, and we've got a small group of three young men and one young lady, and they're all just on a radio program for Liverpool Community Radio, and we're doing a bit of feedback. We're trying to find out what he thought about it. And Jack's really smiling his head off now. Look at his face. Oh, lovely little face. You can squeeze it, couldn't you? You're probably not allowed to do that. Right, we're going to start, and we're going to go round, and we're going to have everyone introduce yourself. So first of all, we're going to start with this young man here. What's your name? No, okay, he's a bit quiet. What's your name?
My name is Jai.
Jai, okay. What's your name?
Cameron.
Cameron.
Rebecca.
Rebecca, okay. And what have we all just done? Have we all just done the last couple of days? What have you made?
Radio.
You made a radio programme, haven't you? So what did you have to do to make your radio programme, Cameron?
We had to say our part, yeah. By looking at a piece of paper.
So a script, you had to write a script, did you? And what was your programme about?
My programme was about diving.
And who did you do it with?
I done it with Mazan.
We just spoke to Mazan. Very, very interesting guy. Right, what was yours about, Rebecca?
Swimming,
right. Okay, so what was what happened in the programme? Who did you have in as a guest?
Alex,
right. Do you know who Alex is? My nephew, I'm his uncle, believe it or not. He's only 2 years younger than me.
Is it real?
He's really my nephew. He's a swimming instructor. So what did he tell you? What did you find out from Alex? It was interesting. Yeah, what did you find out?
The best age is just... start swimming at 3 years old.
Right, so start as young as you can, yeah. And what about yours? What did you find out about divers and diving?
I found out that you have to have really special equipment.
Right. What would happen if you didn't have special equipment?
It would all go wrong and you wouldn't do it like a real diver.
You'd probably get killed, wouldn't you? Yeah, so you've got to be really careful, haven't you? What about you two? What's your programme about?
You know.
I know, but the people who listen to this don't know because they weren't there in the room.
Oh.
Come on, games. What was your programme about?
Games.
Games, computer games, or just hopscotch?
With computer games.
So which computer game are you most interested in?
So far, Minecraft.
Minecraft. What was the other one?
Lego City.
Cut the rope or something like that.
I told you about
but that was before. This is something different.
Everyone doesn't know about cut the rope.
No,
everyone
I do.
No.
Cut the rope is where you have to cut the rope and feed the nim-nim.
It's all in the name, really, isn't it? Cut the rope. All you've got to do is cut the rope. If it was called don't cut the rope, you wouldn't cut the rope. Right. I'm going to ask you a quick question now. And I want you to answer with one word. You only say one word. Right. I'm going to ask you what you thought about doing your radio programme. Say it in one word, so you can say whatever you want. We had awesome before, didn't we? That was a good one, yeah. So what about you, Rebecca? What would be your word about doing the radio programme?
Fantastic.
Fantastic. What about you, Cameron? That was a fantastic word there.
Amazing.
Amazing. What about you, Jay?
I'm thinking.
You're thinking. What about you, Jack? We haven't heard much from you, have we? You're very quiet. You weren't before. You were very noisy
because
before.
I wanted to go in that chair.
Well, we can't have everything, Jack. You know, tomorrow you can go and sit in that chair. We won't be here, though, but you can sit in that chair. Jack, one word to describe how the radio programme was? Sulky. No. What about you, Jay? It's your last chance now. You've got lots of thinking time.
I liked.
Right.
Nimnims.
You like Nimnims, okay. That's two words, actually. Fine, the final bit now before you go back to the classroom. You can ask me one question. If you want. You don't have to ask me a question if you don't want to. Anyone got a question for me? Yeah, go on, Jay.
Do you think Nimnims are cute?
Jay, if I knew what a Nimnim was, I'd answer that question, but I've no idea. But you know what I'm going to do tonight when I get in and go on my computer?
Yeah.
What do you think I'm going to do?
Download.
I'm going to go look for a Nimnim. That's I'm going to look for a Nimnim. I know what a minion is, but I don't know what a Nimnim is. But I'm definitely going to look for just for you, Rebecca.
Where do you work?
Where do I work? I work on Holt Road. We have a radio station on Holt Road. And we work with this group again. We might take you up to the radio station. This is in the studio. We'll have a proper studio. This is our mobile studio, right? You know where I live, don't you? You know what my dogs like, don't you?
I do.
What do you like?
Black and white.
Yeah, they're mad, aren't they? Yeah. You know where I live as well? Yeah. Why didn't you paint the front of my house then? It looks terrible, doesn't it? Right, okay, goodbye. Give yourselves a round of applause. You've done very well today.
I'm just a man. These nights never seem to go to plan. I don't want you to leave. Will you hold my hand? Oh, won't you stay with me? 'Cause you're all. Self-control. Deep down I know this never works, but you can lay with me so it doesn't hurt. Oh, won't you stay with me? 'Cause you're all.
We're in Phoenix School in Fairfield, and we've got two young men who've just finished. What? Two young men, aren't you? We're old men. You're young men.
Yeah.
Okay, and they've just finished a first radio project you've done, haven't you? So, just tell us what your names are first. What's your name?
Sonny,
what's your
Christian.
Name?
Christian.
What's that?
Christian.
Christian. Well done, Christian. That's a great name, Christian. So, Sonny and Christian. And just tell us, Sonny, what your show was about.
Animal safety.
Safety. So what did you try and tell people on that programme? What were you trying to? What was the message sitting around? What was the message you were trying to tell people? Sit still, because I wonder what you're saying if you're spinning around.
Message?
Yeah, what message were you trying to say to people?
About my animals.
About animals. What have you got to know about animal safety?
That you have to not stroke dogs.
Okay, you got to be careful with strange dogs, haven't you? What might happen?
They might bite you.
They might bite you, might they? That would be sad, wouldn't it? I've been bitten by a dog. See that there, that scar?
Yeah.
It's a dog bite. That was a dog I knew.
Dog I knew?
Yeah, I knew. You knew this dog and it still bit me. It wouldn't let me have the bone, you see, that's what it was. Christian, what was your programme about?
Swimming.
Swimming. I've heard all about this swimming program. Tell me about a little bit about it. What did you have to do?
To write about swimming, right. And questions.
Okay, what sort of questions did you ask your guest?
I asked, how old are you?
Right.
What swimming are you? I go to. That's it.
Right. So you found out where he works and everything, did you? You found out how long he's been doing it for? Was it interesting?
He talks to a mermaid.
Did you? Mm. Got a bit of surprise,
really. He finds a mermaid on the rock and he was speaking to it. That's weird.
The person you interviewed, Alex, he's my nephew.
The swimming man. He said he saw a mermaid.
A mermaid?
Mermaid on the beach.
My nephew, Alex Cannon. I grew up with him. He was like my brother, but he's actually my nephew. So... Did you find it interesting? When did you find out all the facts about swimming? Did you have to go on the internet for them? Now, where did you get all your facts from?
On the street.
And did you type your scripts up and everything?
Yeah.
Did you read your scripts? Did you read them in a nice clear voice? And do you think when people listen to it, they're going to find it interesting? Why do you think that is?
Because it's louder.
Because it's louder? Because it was nice and clear that you did, yeah. What about you, Sonny? What about your programme? Do you think people are going to find it interesting when they listen to it?
Yeah.
What was your guest like?
Huh?
What was your guest like?
I didn't have a guest.
You didn't have a guest? No? Okay. Alright. So, would you like to do it again?
Yeah.
Why would you like to do it again?
You're my guest.
I like it.
You like, because you like it?
You're my guest.
How was your guest? What was your guest like?
Good.
It was good, thank you very much. You get your check in the post. Right,
he's saying he was
rude. I know, well, I'm going to sack him later. He's not going to have a job tomorrow, so that's easily done. I'm going to ask you to say one word about the radio.
He said he'll just come out.
I told you he's definitely sacking him. Just one word, how would you describe the radio programme in one word? Can you think of a word, Sonny?
Huh?
Can you think of a word to describe how you felt about the radio programme?
Good.
Very
good.
Very good. Okay.
Yeah.
Anything better than very good?
Can you
think of another word better than very good?
Amazing.
Amazing, that's a great name.
Excellent.
Amazing and excellent. Oh. What about you, Christy?
Fantastic.
Fantastic. Okay. We might be doing it again. And if you did do it again, would you want to have another go at it? Yeah? Okay. Now, as a special treat.
When I'm bigger, I'm going to wait here on this.
Okay. Special treat, you can ask me one question if you want. About anything. No? You haven't got a question, it doesn't matter.
How old are you?
How old am I? Why does everyone want to know how old people is? Someone else asked that question. I'm 58 years old.
58?
I'm 59 in 2 weeks. That's really old, that, isn't it? You thought I was about 32, didn't you?
Somebody was older than you. Do you know how old he was? He was 90.
Right, well, I'm not 90 yet. So old are you? You're 8 or 9? Are you 8 or 9?
8.
8, okay. Well, you've got another 50 years' time.
He looks like he's older than me.
You'll be the same age as me, and I'll be 108.
Right. Whoa.
You'll be 108.
And I'm still around, you can interview me then, and I'll say, what's it like to be 58? And you'll say, it's alright. It's like being a bit like being 8, but with 50 years added on. Okay, so thanks very much for being on. Give yourselves a round of applause, because you've done really well.
Clap, 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 clap.
How old are you?